It's hard to find good news these days, unless you're in North Dakota, where good news is exploding under your feet. Economist Jason Sorens made a chart showing that North Dakota leads the nation in personal income growth in 6 of the last 7 years. Okay. Only Connecticut and D.C. beat it in per capita income. So why is it that every state county has a 14% jump in income growth? Is it a burgeoning market for sunflower meat? The sensuous appeal of granite boulders? No, it's fracking. How come the media doesn't report that? How come the president doesn't point to North Dakota and say, hey, that's pretty awesome? It's because North Dakota's win is seen as their loss, which is weird since natural gas was something that liberals used to love. It's true. When it was expensive, it was great. Now that it's cheap, it's evil. It's like the SUV. When only celebrities were chauffeured in them, they were cool. Then when we all got them, they became fossil fiends.
True.
So why does the left hate something that creates jobs, makes us energy independent, which increases security abroad? Because it's not government. The fracking revolution is a triumph of humanity, not bureaucracy. It's a reminder that when government gets out of the way, good things happen. It's sad that something so awesomely American is ignored by our government because they didn't build it. But what do you expect? The only thing the president seems to make these days are excuses.
Womp womp.
I had to add a sound effect there
at
the end. Eric, you're the expert in all things oil and fuel. What I don't understand is fracking was seen as green energy because it was natural. Why did all of a sudden they change their mind?
Well, I think they're trying to change their mind back into convincing that people that it is safe. Now, there are a bunch of studies saying the fracking, they're concerned about the water table. The water table is going to be safe. Can I just point out how dumb these liberals are? In North Dakota, because the economy is so good, so strong, they're hiring people. But not only are they hiring people, they're paying them more to get there. So the wages are going up. So you have that benefit. But when wages go up, what else goes up?
Taxes.
Tax revenue. Exactly.
So their schools are awesome.
Bingo.
Their schools are great.
They
can hire the best.
Right.
Exactly. I'm surprised that they don't want it more because it's better for the global warming.
Well, there are five problems, Dana, that fracking solves. It makes us energy independent. Mm-hmm. It's less polluting, mm-hmm. provides jobs, mm-hmm. makes money for the government, mm-hmm. lowers energy costs. Mm-hmm. Is there a downside?
Yes. The billionaire Tom Steyer, who is supporting Democrats, doesn't like it.
Oh. Well, there you go. Forget about it then.
That is true.
One, it creates 180,000 jobs in Pennsylvania. It's banned in New York. Do you think they got to lift that ban and help upstate New York become as rich as all these Manhattanites in media?
Let me ask you a simple question.
The answer was
would you prefer to live in North Dakota or New York?
I can live anywhere if I'm in a walking distance to a liquor store or a strip club.
Is that the deal?
And a gym.
A gym? Oh, my God.
You don't go to strip clubs.
I know.
But the rest was true.
Well,
no, but I mean, look, there's a reason. I mean, you know, it's pretty obvious. Yes, their incomes are going up. You got to pay people to move there because people don't want to live there.
Yeah. And it's
people
smart,
are.
It's
and
smart.
You say, what's the issue? Guess what? People are worried about the water table that Eric's
But the studies are great. The
Department of Energy just said it's not a problem.
Yeah, well, we were. People are worried. That's
I wish they
they're just worried
frack in Detroit.
Science.
They could use some help.
They should be fracking everywhere.
Oh, well, this is the point. So why not? Because most experts will tell you if it wasn't for increased oil and gas production on private lands, the U.S. might have even slipped back into, you know, worse recession. So you would think they would want the country to move forward so that you can provide for all these entitlements and boost the economy. But instead, they seem to be against everything that makes sense.
No, but President Obama was clearly against fracking earlier in his political career. He's come around since it's so successful. It's provided so many jobs. It's brought the price of oil. It's kept a lid on the price of oil.
He actually brags about the natural gas.
He's evolved on natural gas the way he evolved on gay marriage, I guess.
Yeah, and exactly. Then, could they be linked? I don't know.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. It's Friday. I'm mailing it in, people.
Remember the good old days, Facebook Friday?
This is some of your best stuff.
This is unbelievable.
It's a combination of factors. Okay. When we come back, how long would you wait in line for the iPhone 6? Some waited for 2 weeks. Are they insane? Of course they are. You'll hear from some of the biggest Apple fanatics when we get back.